The AFL has a concussion problem, and Cade Colajasny knows it firsthand.
It was a heavy, heavy knock, wasn't it?
Knee to the back of the head, yeah.
The Melbourne and Gold Coast winger had his 80-game career cut short, aged just 23.
I had roughly around 15 concussions all up throughout my career. It feels like, in a way, my brain's been rewired. My cognitive state's not where it was pre-draft.
The AFL's all too aware of the issue, which is why they commissioned neurophysiologist Dr. Alan Pearce to study the brain function of former players back in 2016. But Dr. Pearce believes he was set up to fail. Today, alleging the AFL repeatedly refused him access to their 600-strong database before finally providing contacts for 40 former players 18 months into the two-year project. The study was never completed. In a statement, an AFL spokesperson said that
past AFL players were encouraged to participate in Dr. Pearce's study funded by the AFL, but regrettably, they largely chose not to participate, preferring to focus on clinical care.
Much of that clinical care was provided by Dr. Paul McCrory, a leading but divisive voice heavily involved in developing the AFL's concussion protocols.
And the feared CTE, the risk is about 4% of retired athletes get it. So there's something about those 4% that's different to the other 96%. Is it a genetic risk? Is it related to alcohol or drugs or other things?
In 2017, Dr. McCrory treated Colajasny after he'd suffered 3 concussions in a week.
And after a few clinical tests, he diagnosed that it was neck-related, so I was cleared to play. I remember telling myself, this is 100%, has nothing to do with my neck, this is from head trauma, this is brain-related, this is not neck-related.
In 2018, McCrory gave an enforceable undertaking to regulators not to perform any more neurodiagnostic procedures. And last month, he resigned as the chair of the influential Concussion in Sport group after being accused of plagiarising other people's research. McCrory has been contacted for comment.
If this is a person whose integrity is being questioned, and he was at the forefront of a lot of the decisions that were made around concussion and protecting players, then what does that do for those that are seeking to take on the AFL?
But as the AFL investigates McCrory, the organisation itself is being asked how serious it really is about concussion research.
I think it's a grenade about to explode for the AFL.
Associate Professor Alan Pearce has been good enough to join us. Alan, let's be clear up front here. Do you believe the AFL commissioned research and then tried to prevent you from completing it?
Well, it looks that way. I went in there with good faith that we would be doing this research in a collaborative fashion, but it sort of became quite clear to me that things weren't going to plan, and I was getting quite concerned, especially about 18 months into the contract.
Why would they want to undermine their own research? What's in it for them?
I don't know, because I think that they want to, you know, help understand this issue, but I think there is also a concern around if the results are showing a negative outcome, what does that mean? You know, is there an existential threat to the sport?
But is it your sense that that's the kind of result you might have gotten?
Well, I'd already published a paper where I had studied 40 Australian football players at elite levels and club levels, and we were showing changes in the brain function and physiology of the brain. So I guess it was something to look at further and was possibly expecting, similar results.
Alan, from your research in studies like that one you were just talking about, do you think that there is, or have you seen, a reluctance from players to be involved in this kind of research?
Oh, look, absolutely. And I guess that's one of the things that I've always said up front, that we have what we call selection bias, where players who have concerns will come, but others who are not wanting to find out then will not.
What would you have had the AFL... Like, they've said they've encouraged those players. So is it possible that actually they did uphold their end of the bargain, it's just it didn't deliver what you were after?
In that particular contract, I had offered that I would try and recruit players based upon my previous research, because I had a sort of a network going, but I was specifically told that with this contract that they would select players and they would choose players to send to me based upon their particular screening. So my concern with that is that it's not a properly randomised sample. What we want to try and do is encourage players from all parts of the game, not just ones that the AFL felt comfortable sending me.
Alan, what's some of the most concerning data that you found within current players, former players, throughout your studies?
For me, it's been looking at the what we call the physiology of the brain. So not so much around the fact that they're concerned of their memory or not being able to focus or their concentration, but actually showing that there is what we call pathophysiology. In some respects, I was seeing a form of advanced ageing in these players.
Do you think that the AFL wants to appear like it's doing something on this issue without actually doing something?
Well, I think all the sports around the world are in that sort of same boat. So they want to show that they're doing something. But, you know, this is one of the reasons why we need to have independent research. If they want to fund, then send it to a third party like the National Health and Medical Research Council, who can then distribute the funding to independent researchers based on a competitive process, not picking and choosing who can do the research.
Alan, thanks so much for your time tonight.
You're welcome. Thank you.
I mean, the claims aside of whether the AFL, are not trying to work this out, you know, sincerely, it's what a problem it is, and it's across all sports. But AFL, you know, you can, they have made rules. They've changed the game a lot to protect the head. But how much are they prepared to change it?
Well, think about what it was like previously. Yeah. You look back at that now, knowing what we do know now, and remember seeing players knocked out and then they'd come back and it was seen as this amazing thing, and now you're
thank
just
God
like,
it's not like that anymore. Yeah. That's really hard to watch now. Horrible. You know, concussion used to be a very light term and now it's got a real heaviness about it.
But when people won't participate in these studies, are they going to say no to a dream like this?
When they're currently playing, I think that's a real issue. You can view statements from the AFL and APRA on our website.